That's why when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane, he said, Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. But I believe in that moment, he realized that you and I was going to need him. He realized his assignment. And he couldn't abort the mission prematurely. And so he had to go all the way through. And he said, when after, I think he had that revelation, he said, you know what, nevertheless, not my will, but your will be done. Let's go. Go on and take me. They didn't take his life. He laid it down. He surrendered. And then he got up. Hallelujah. Oh, that's the God you serve. Glory to God. The innocent took the place of the guilty. And because he took your place, even though you've done things that you're guilty of, covered by the blood. That's the gift of God and God of praise. If you feel that you've forgotten about the covering of the blood, and you may have done something out of disobedience or forgotten the sacrifice, haven't lived and done some things that are words. You said, you know what, I'm sorry. We invite you to come right now. Come and get it right with the Lord. Whatever it is, God wants it. And he wants you to give it to him so he can work it out on your behalf. Amen. We have to know, and without a doubt, that we are. Arbitrarily that the coverage we thought we had, we really don't. God has given us an opportunity to assure the coverage that we have. And if you've been without it for a while, guess what? Then you activate the policy. He'll make the effective date. He'll retro it. But we are covered by the blood of Jesus. And so we invite you to come. If you just want prayer on today, we invite you to come, that we can pray with you, that we can pray for you, that we can stand in the gap. There's power in prayer. Hallelujah.